My name is Darko Mitevski. I'm originally from Macedonia, from Skopje. At the moment, I'm living and working in Bremen, in Germany. I'm head of NaturKultur FAO, which is an NGO that is organizing international mobilities for young people across Europe. And I'm head of Kulturhaus, which is a social enterprise that is providing space for NGOs and other types of organizations to do their training activities there. So kind of like a training center. Well, I was an entrepreneur at first. So for several years, I had my own company. It was a business development consulting company. And I was working with small and medium enterprises, trying to reorganize them, to put strategy behind the business, or to develop different processes to simply to reorganize them so they would function much better. And I realized that many of the organizations that I'm working in as a consultant, like, they were valueless organizations. So basically the only thing that they cared about is the profits that they're making. So there was no care for employees or no care for the consumers. So basically they were running their own business ideas and they were making money, and I couldn't work for that kind of organizations anymore. So basically I decided to quit one day, and I knew that that would mean that I would get 10 to 20 times less income, and I knew that I would have to build from the beginning, to start from zero. But I also knew that I'm going to work in teams that I choose, with people that share my values, and then we're going to provide development opportunities for other people, and then we're just going to be making the world to be a better place. So that's why I kind of shifted into social entrepreneurship. I wouldn't say it's the family. I would say that the entrepreneurial spirit came from my family, but not the social part of it. Like, I would say that the groups of friends, the social groups that I belong to, like, we had like this kind of conversations. I was working as a student in different development NGOs for young people, and then like those core values got like deeply embedded in me, and then it's kind of like returning to my roots when I started this social enterprise, to something that I believe in, and to build it together with those friends, to build value-based teams that share common value and common goals. And then that's why the organizations, both organizations, are developing so quickly. Yeah, I think it's helping me a lot, because like most of the organizational management I learned there, also in other things, but yeah, kind of I learned all the things that I like to do, and I learned all the things that I don't like to do. So it's kind of a mix between the two things. And for example, I also learned like which compromises I don't want to do, you know. So it's kind of crucial that I had that kind of insight of running company and like consulting big companies, like to how to run their businesses. I kind of realized which compromises I don't want to make. To be sincere, no one is full-time. Everyone is project-based, but like that doesn't mean that like they have sustainable incomes. We are four people that we are working full-time. And we have around 10 to 12 people that are working on part-time basis, like on different parts of the year. They come in and they came out, because based on the structural funds that we receive as funding, like we had to make this kind of like rotating platform organization that would suit the incomes that we get, and therefore like be able to have like different kind of profiles of people working for us. And probably there are around 30 volunteers that every now and then help with different kind of activities. Some of them are paid, some of them are volunteering. So it's value-based teams, value-based organization that we connect for the same reasons. And then we don't have like hierarchy. So I'm having a style of horizontal leader. I don't tell people what to do. I'm not doing micromanagement, and I'm not checking their schedules. It's kind of based on their own responsibility and of their own flexibility. And basically what we are trying to do is to find people that have talents that suit the needs of the organization, and then we incorporate them into the organization where they can utilize their talents and grow the same way that the organization is doing. So with their own development, the development of the organization, kind of it's a win-win situation for both. So when you have like that kind of setup, it's very easy to run a social enterprise where you have like people who are there for the right reasons, and then like you share common values, and then everything else is basically like we're a very resourceful team that like finds answers for all the challenges that we encounter on the way. There are different kinds of definitions of social enterprises, and we have two different types of social enterprise. So NaturKultur is purely an NGO that gets funding for their activities, structured, dedicated funding that only part of that funding we decide what can we spend it on, like on the things that we think. But through the years we developed Kulturhaus, which is a social enterprise for profit, but a part of the business is, there are several kinds of goals. One is community based, that like we want to develop the community where we're going to do community-based projects. For example, a lot of the activities, the neighbors will be involved, and then we're going to send the kids and all the youngsters from the neighborhood, we're going to send them on international mobility activities, and we're going to bring a lot of internationals that are going to mix with the community. So basically this cultural exchange, but also infrastructure. For example, parts of the road has to be fixed, or the bus stands have to be fixed, and then like we're asking our youngsters, like as part of their development activities, to work on fixing those bus stands, or like to build benches for the community. So basically there are a lot of activities that we kind of mix together with the local community. Also the plan is to continue working with the schools, where on a regular basis we have the pupils to come here, and then they learn different kind of things as part of their extracurricular activities. So it's not only about the profit. The profit is kind of like the idea is that the social enterprise kind of supports the NGO into further development, so we can kind of guarantee full-time salaries and things like this. And on another side, it's going to be projects that like the broader community is going to benefit from, and also the NGOs. Like one of the key goals of why we're doing this is to support all small and medium NGOs that don't have the capacity to run their projects in different sorts of venues, and then like the same struggles that we had, like let's say 5 years ago, and like we're going to support them. So they're going to have special conditions, they're going to have discounts on their prices, just so we kind of give them help in order for them to develop and to continue doing community-based projects. I would say several ways, like we're kind of like a social enterprise, an NGO, but like we take the things like very professional. So basically we're doing statistics on the satisfaction of the participants from our projects. So on each project we do a very detailed evaluation process, where not just we want to measure our success on one side, like to see do they like or not our activities, but like we take detailed feedback in terms of written forms, but also in terms of interviews of what are the improvements that we can make. And then we sit down with our team, and then we're talking about how to implement those improvements. On another side, like the recognition comes from the donors of more and more projects that we get funded, and then like the level of the importance of the projects, it's getting increased. For example, we're leading a project that's called Trainers Library, that's collecting resources for self-development of trainers who work with youth groups across Europe. that it's a 2 years project with very large budget, and then like we are running it together in partnership with other organizations. So the trust that has been entitled to us from the donors, it's kind of one measurement of success. So there are many projects. I just mentioned like Trainers Library. That's, we believe that like when we create this platform, that there are going to be self-development resources for nearly 6.5 million youth workers and social workers. They're working with youth on the whole territory of Europe. We believe that the quality of the youth work is going to increase when we have more educated youth workers. Another project that we have been working on is called Spark Catcher, where we were doing a year-long research of how to provide entrepreneurship opportunities for young people with fewer opportunities. So in fewer opportunities, we consider people with disabilities, early school dropouts, drug addicts, delinquents, and other kinds of vulnerable groups that they're not integrated in society. They're kind of stuck in a certain moment of time. And then with helping them to discover what their talents are and providing entrepreneurial opportunities, how to utilize their talents, we're trying to reintegrate them into society. So we're going across Europe and collecting that kind of stories. And then we have someone that we made videos, we put them on camera, like we collected the resources, and then like these resources, these materials are being used right now to work with other people with fewer opportunities and in order to integrate better in society. There are many other projects where we do just like cultural youth exchanges, or we're involved in all the processes of improving the quality of youth work in Europe on political level, let's say advocating for the rights and working conditions for the NGOs to provide better structure of the funding, so we have more freedom to decide or more freedom that will allow us to drive our own development rather to kind of use whatever is left from the funding in infrastructure and in people. So to all the people who want to start social enterprises, I would suggest to go for it. You know, it's a totally different kind of challenge than working for a typical company, because a lot of different parameters take place. It's a different structure of the team. It's a different set of roles and responsibilities. There are different kinds of motivational factors for the employees or the team members. The celebration is different. The cohesion within the company or the organization is different. I've read a lot of papers, and everyone was telling me that it's just like going to be a big failure trying to build organizations with friends. But like we are still running and doing a lot of activities. We are like very recognized for our work, and our organization or our system is based on integrating friends or creating friendships, not just co-workers. So we have like different sets of values embedded in our organizations, and it's a totally different playground. It's totally challenging, and we change the world. You know, it's not a joke. It's like we have concrete examples and concrete like proofs of young people that their life took a different path after coming to our projects, or the influence of our projects to different kinds of social groups. So it's very beneficial, and kind of it's priceless experience. So.